So again, good morning ABM 12 and then GAS 12. Today we're going to discuss the Applied Economics chapter 2 lesson 6, the market structures and its competitive environment. Okay, so market is defined as the environment where the interaction of supply and demand and the subsequent determination of price occurs. So dito yung nagpapalitan ng ano eh, ng products and ng money yung buyer and seller. Yan. Pero yung market sa principles of marketing, ibang usapan naman yun. Taon naman yung tinutukoy doon. Pero pag sa applied economics, when we say market, ito yung place no, wherein nagkakaroon ng exchange between the buyer and the seller. Okay, so market structures can go from having an industry with a lot of firms offering the same or different products, or the other extreme where there exists an industry with just one firm. Okay, so for this lesson or for this chapter, we have here the learning competency. We should be able to explain market structure. For example, yung mga market competition, monopoly, oligopoly, monopolistic competition. And differentiate the different market structures. Explain how the price and output are determined in the different market structures. Okay, so we can do this with your partner. Ayan. I think parang later na lang, no, if may time kayo. And in this activity, you need to pair up with another classmate. Explain how you will price the commodity and how much output you are going to produce given the different scenarios. Okay, so kunwari na lang, or you can have your partner na lang. And, or you can imagine na lang, no? Ayan. So if your company is the only one that can manufacture and sell products, will you set the high price or low? Ayan, pwede kayo mag-chat high or low. Ayan, and why? And if your company is the only one that can manufacture and sell the product C, will you set the price high or low? And you can just type high or low. And then, for those who can explain no, kung bakit high or low, then that's good. Okay, so yun, chat lang sa chat box. If i-offer nyo yung product C ng price, higher price or lower price. Oh, anyone? Okay. May sabi ni Irene Palabon, mag-set siya ng higher price. Okay, so bakit kaya, no? Bakit high price for the product C? You can freely type in the chat box. Okay, so again, yung question, no? If your company is the only one that can manufacture and sell product Z, will you set the price high or low and why? Okay, you can just type in the chat box, high or low. Higher price po kasi unique naman and masatangkalikin pa rin po ng customer. High po kasi wala naman pong ibang kukompetensya kaya di masyado maagawan ng attention sa buyers. Since the company ko lang naman yung mga may ganong product at wala pong ibang competitors na may ganong product, pwede ko siyang taasan ng price. Okay? So, lahat ng sinabi nyo, correct yun. Since yun nga, wala ka namang kaagaw, no? Wala ka namang kakompetensya. So, wala ka rin kakompetensya sa pag-set ng price. Okay, so without considering the government, no, we can set the high price, the price high. If your company is the only one selling products, will you satisfy the quantity demanded by the consumer? Why or why not? Yan. In Tagalog, no, kung yung company mo lang yung nagbebenta or nagpo-produce ng products, masasatisfy mo kaya yung quantity demanded ng mga consumers? Why or why not? Yan. Yes muna, yes or no. Okay, masasatisfy mo kaya? Yes or no? And why or why not? Okay. Sabi ni Irene, yes. Okay, sa iba naman, yes or no? I think there is no correct, there is no wrong answer naman dito. This can be yes or no. So it depends naman sa capacity ng company if they can satisfy the quantity demanded. Okay. Yes, so depende sa production ng product ng company. So there is no wrong answer naman dito. Ayan. Even in this first question, there is no wrong answer din naman. You can set the low price. Ayan, para mas matangkilik mong bumili pa ng product mo yung mga consumer, or you can set it high since you have the privilege, or ikaw lang naman kasi yung nagse-sell noon. Okay, so there is no wrong answer in these questions naman. So yes, ma'am, kasi po yung mga customer are willing and able to buy po, depende rin sa price. Okay, so yon, there is no wrong answer naman dito. So depende sa capacity ng company, no, if they can produce such quantity demanded. If there are small firms selling product S and you are one of them, how will you set the price? Okay, so kunyari maraming kunyari katulad sa baklaran, and mga small mga bangketa, and you are all selling this t-shirt, and paano mo isi-set yung price? Yan, pinaka lowest price or pinaka highest price? So again, no, depend. There is no wrong answer pa rin in this question. Yan, you can set the price higher or you can set the price lower. So depende, no, sa promotion mo. Yan, a little bit higher or lower. Ayan. So siyempre pwedeng lower, no, hanggang parang pwedeng lowest, pero just make sure lang na hindi ka lugi or hindi naman siya ang tatama doon sa pinaka-capital mo. Yes, lowest price, pero kailangan po may kita pa rin. Same price or a little bit higher or lower. Okay, pwedeng same price din, no, with a small firm. So, pagalingan na lang mag-promote. Ayan. So, how do market structures affect our consumption patterns? Okay. So first market structure natin is the perfect competition, also known as competitive market. This is a market structure with many buyers and sellers trading identical products. Buyers and sellers must accept market prices. They are said to be price takers. Okay, so ano kaya yung naiisip niyong industry na wherein we can see many buyers and sellers trading identical or same products, and then yung buyers and sellers just accept the market price and said to be the price takers. Ano kaya yung mga industry na naiisip nyo na ganito yung ano niya, definition niya. Okay, we can say yung mga wet market, no, yung mga ano, yeah, yung wet market, for example, wherein we can buy the meat and maraming same naman na ganun. Same products na ganun, yung mga nagtitinda ng mga gulay, yan yung mga palengke, yan. Yan. Ano pa ba, yung maraming buyers and sellers trading identical products and the buyers and sellers just accept the market prices. For example, Baclaran, ayan, Divisoria, same lang naman sila ng most likely, no, same sila or identical sila ng products na ino-offer. Okay, so for example, during the harvest season, the main season for mangoes in Guimaras, the prices of mangoes from one fruit seller to another converge to a common price. And mga palengke. For consumers, mangoes from Guimaras are perceived to taste the same. So consumers do not see any difference among mangoes in the market. So, kumbaga, ang chuncheck na lang nila dito ay yung presyo. Pero more likely, no, hindi naman nagkakalayo ng presyo yung mga mangoes doon sa Guimaras. Okay, so for the perfect competition, we can see here the following. The quantity 500, 600, and 700. And same price, parehas natin. Ayan, and then total revenue, multiply the quantity and the price. So 5,000, 6,000, 7,000. And then total cost, ayan, pasa man ang gagaling yung to cost. Siyempre yung pagbili mo ng ano, yung pagtatanim mo dun sa cost ay sa mangoes na yon, ayun. Anything else na para makuha mo yung mangoes na i-sell mo or ibebenta mo. Okay, marginal revenue wala, marginal cost wala. I think ano to, equilibrium or tawag dito, ano ba yon? Basta may ano na siya, equilibrium na siya. Break even na tinatawag. Okay? 10, 9.5, 10, and 13. Okay, so profit and loss, 1,150, and then 600 and 400, 1,200 and 900. Okay, so mas better na mag-sell ka ng 600 yung quantity. Okay, so the price, marginal revenue, and demand curve in a perfectly competitive market is a horizontal line. To maximize profit, the firm needs to produce at the point where MR, marginal revenue, is equal to marginal cost, or at Q as this. A perfectly competitive market, firms produces quantity at the point where marginal revenue is equal to marginal cost. Okay, so here, again, meron tayong graph. So, yung blue is the price. Yan, yung blue is the price. And then yung pink, yung marginal revenue. And then yung yellow is the marginal cost. Okay, so habang dumadami yung quantity, lumalaki yung marginal cost. Okay? Yan. So yung 600 9.5 9.5 or yan. 9.5. Okay, and then pag 700 yung quantity, ayan, lumalaki din yung marginal cost. Okay, so itong ano na to, itong point na to, which is MR to MC, ito yung parang equilibrium niya, or tinatawag na break-even, wherein same yung revenue and then yung cost. Okay, so dapat pag nagbenta tayo, tawag dito, hindi lalaki yung marginal cost. Kasi pag ito, itong part na to, mas mataas yung cost sa revenue or dun sa price, then malulugi tayo. Okay, dapat dito lang sa part na to. Pipili ka lang ng quantity na dito. So more likely like 610 siguro and below. Ayan. Okay. So next, so again, no, sa perfect competition, same daw, most likely same yung marginal cost and marginal revenue. Next, this is a market monopoly naman. This is a market structure where there is a single seller of a particular product or type of product in the market. Okay, this is a market structure where the buyer is a single seller of a particular product or type of product in the market. Okay? So, meaning, siya lang yung nagbebenta ng ganong product sa lugar na yun. Okay? So, ano yung naiisip niyong business na ganon? Parang siya lang yung nag-o-offer ng ganong product sa lugar na yun. Okay? So, may naiisip ba kayo? Ayan. The firm exhibits an enormous amount of market power because of the absence of rivals or direct competitors. Wala siyang kakompetensya. Siya lang yung kayang mag-produce ng ganung product or service na yun. Okay, may naisip kayo na business na ganun? Okay, you can just type in the chat box if may naisip kayong company na siya lang yung ganun, siya lang yung provider ng ganung product or service na yun in that place. Okay, so for example, Meralco. Am I right, Meralco? Siya lang yung nagpo-provide ng electricity sa lugar na yon. Wala namang iba, di ba? Wala nang ibang nagpo-provide pa ng electricity aside from Meralco. So, monopoly yon. What else? Yes, Maynilad. Ayan. So, more likely, pag Maynilad, kunyari, more likely sa ano to eh, sa NCR. Ayan, pag NCR, more likely Maynilad. Okay? So, what else? Meron pa kayong iba? Okay. Dati ano eh, sa telephone dati, nung wala pang Globe and Smart, dati PLDT eh. Ayan. So, yon sa Leyte naman, Soleco, ang distributor ng kuryente nila. No, hindi naman naabot ang Meralco doon, no? Kasi ang Meralco dito lang ata sa Luzon eh, or bandang NCR. Yan yung Meralco. And then sa ibang probinsya, iba na yung distributor. Iba na yung distributor ng electricity. Yan, dati sa telecommunication na monopolize ng PLDT eh. Pero since nag-extend na ng product line ang Globe at Smart, nagkaroon na rin sila ng Wi-Fi. Ayun. So, ayun. I think unti lang, no? Unti lang. Pero most likely, kung mapapansin nyo, yung in-offer nila ay yung mga basic necessities natin. Or yung mga utilities, no? Something that involves the natural resources. So yun nga, dapat yung Meralco na yan and then yung Maynilad na yan, dapat ano yan eh, government yung may-ari, hindi private company. So it should be tawag dito, handled by the government. Yan, kasi basic necessities natin yan. Yung tubig at kuryente. Okay? So yun, dapat hindi private companies ang may-ari niyan. Dapat government. It's because basic necessities natin yun. So do you agree? No, dapat hindi private companies yung may-ari nun? Okay, do you agree nun? Do you agree ba? Na dapat private companies or government yung may-ari? government or private companies ang dapat magmay-ari ng ano, ng mga basic necessities provider natin, such as yung kuryente and then yung tubig. Okay, so what do you think? Ayan, most of us answered government. Yan, kay yan. Which is correct, no? Dapat talaga government yung may-ari nun. It's because basic necessities natin yun at it involves the natural resources. No, I think it should be government. It should be, it should not be the private companies. Okay, so next. Yeah, example, in Metro Manila and nearby suburbs surrounding it, electricity is provided by just one supplier. In this case, it is example of monopoly in a given geographical area. Okay, so in monopoly, ayan, so we have the following quantity. For example, 100, 200, 300. So for the price, 16, 15, 14. And then total revenue and total cost, 16, 900. Ayan, as you can see, no, kahit walang quantity, may total cost pa din, of course. Kasi syempre, kahit hindi ka nakabenta, meron ka parang nagastos doon. So 16900 2338 and for the total revenue 300 for 4200. And then marginal revenue and marginal cost 16 4 16 4 14 14 and then 12 15. So as you can see, no, mas better na halos same yung 100 and 200. Ayan. Okay, let's check, no, kung ano ba yung for the monopoly. So as you can see, we have here the demand. And habang lumalaki yung quantity, habang mas lumiliit yung presyo, lumiliit yung demand. Okay. And then, kakaiba, no, yung behavior ng monopoly. Ayan. Habang bumababa yung price. Ay, tama. Ayan. Ayan. So, okay. For the pink one, no, yung pink line, as you can see, habang bumababa yung presyo, tumataas yung demand. So for this one, I think let's estimate na 13 to. 13, so ano siya, 300 yung demand niya for that. Okay, for the marginal cost naman, ayan, habang tumataas yung presyo, tumataas din yung quantity. Ayan, habang tumataas yung quantity, tumataas yung presyo for the marginal cost. Okay, so parang ano siya, directly proportional yung price at yung quantity. Okay. For the marginal revenue, same sila ng behavior ng demand. And habang, habang tumadami yung quantity, bumababa yung yung presyo. Or, habang bumababa yung presyo, mas tumataas yung dami ng quantity for the marginal revenue. I think yung, yung equilibrium niya andito sa point na to, wherein nag-meet yung NC at yung MR. Okay, so again, yung marginal revenue, same behavior with the demand. So habang dumadami yung quantity, bumababa yung presyo. Ayan, or habang bumababa yung presyo, dumadami yung demand for the lower price. Ayan, so inversely proportional yung price and quantity for demand and marginal revenue. And then for the marginal cost, ayan, directly proportional yung price at yung quantity for the marginal cost. So for the monopolistic competition, A monopolistic competitive market possesses the features of both monopoly and perfect competition. Okay, so combination siya ng perfect competition and monopoly. Ibig sabihin, tawag dito, marami ka ng buyer and then at the same time, marami ding seller. Tapos, price taker lahat. Yan. Pero parang walang ganito eh. Walang ganitong business in, ano eh. Parang walang ganitong types ng, ano, walang ganitong companies or business na nag-exist. Na meron ng, ano, na meron ng monopolistic and then perfect competition pa. So the graph of monopolistic competitive market mimics the graph of a monopoly. So the output is determined at the point where MR is equal to MC. And the price is derived from the demand curve. Okay, this is characterized. Next naman, yung oligopoly. Ayan, tiga mo, wala siyang example. Kasi parang wala talagang ganitong company na monopolistic competition. Monopoly at the same time, perfect competition pa. Next natin is yung oligopoly. This is characterized by a fewer sellers producing similar or differentiated products. Although illegal, mass oligopolists may collude with one another to set prices and output levels to benefit all of them. Okay, so ito yung graph ng ano, graph ng oligopoly. And I think this one should be the demand. Okay, so the graph of cooperating oligopolies is like the graph of monopoly. Okay, so they produce output at the intersection of MR is equal to MC denoted at QA. Okay, so ito yung quantity and then yung price. I think this should ano, itong pink na to, demand to, ha? Huwag tayong mali to. And this one is MC. Marginal cost, marginal revenue for the green one, and then demand for the marginal cost. Pero dapat hindi to marginal cost, demand to demand. So again, marginal cost, demand, and then MR. So same din naman sila ng ano, ng monopoly. Same graph sila ng monopoly. Okay, yun nga lang, pa-curve yung kay ano, kay marginal cost. Okay, so again, pag we'll see the demand curve and then ito yung intersection ng demand and then yung marginal cost. And then yung equilibrium din ng marginal revenue and then marginal cost. So meaning, ito yung point na to wherein same si marginal cost and then yung marginal revenue na tinatawag. Okay, so at meaning, no, at this price, ayan, pag if we'll extend the line at this price, ayan, ibig sabihin magiging equal yung marginal cost and then yung marginal revenue. How does a perfectly competitive market determine their price and output? Okay, so naalala natin, no, 'di ba yung perfect competition? Paano doon nila na determine yung price and output? So I guess yung ano nila, yung ka-same nilang similar, ka-same nilang seller din. For example, yung katulad ng kanina, pag marami kayo nagbebenta ng same product, then you can set the price a little lower or a little higher Basta walang ano, basta meron ka pa rin kita. Okay, same din sa output. Okay, so yun, we have here the self-assessment. And identify the correct term being described in each each statement. This is the market structure with many buyers and sellers who are all price takers. So we have ano the di ba, we have the oligopoly, monopolistic, a monopoly, and then monopolistic competition, and then perfect competition. Alin siya doon? This is the market structure with many buyers and sellers who are all price takers. Kung naalala natin kanina. Yan, just type lang sa chat box. Market structure with many buyers and sellers who are all price takers. Okay, so ako na lang magsabi, perfect competition. This allow firm to dictate the selling price for the good it is selling in the market. Okay, so I think ano to eh, pwede rin tong sa oligopoly wherein price setter kasi ang sa oligopoly since sila lang naman yung nagbebenta, and then konti lang silang nagbebenta noon, and then differentiated yung product, they can set the price, and then this can be also the government. This contains both the characteristic of monopoly and perfect competition. Yan yung monopolistic competition naman to. So this is the process of distinguishing the firm's products and other similar products. Benchmarking. The process of distinguishing the firm's product from other similar products. This gives the owner the legal right to exclusively produce the product. Ano yun? This gives the owner the legal right to exclusively produce the product. Na parang license yun eh. For example, mga copyrights, like kayo lang yung pwede mag-produce nun, and you have to ask permission for that company na nag-produce nun. Okay, so yun, just to wrap up, perfectly competitive or perfect competition, our firms have buyers and sellers who are all price taker. Firms with monopolistic market structure are price makers. They are able to dictate the selling price in the market. Ayan. Actually, yung oligopoly din, price makers din sila. A monopolistic competitive market, yan, both monopoly and then perfect competition. Oligopoly is characterized by having a few firms selling differentiated and homogeneous goods or services. Okay, any question? About market structure? Okay, so if wala na, we can now end the class. Thank you. Thank you. Bye.